Hey, this is a quick video on how to get the settlers running in DOSBox with the sound working. So I'm actually using D-Fend Reloaded, which is like a front end for DOSBox, which quite makes things easier to use. You can get it from this address here. I'll put this link in the video description. I'm using the zip version. If you scroll down, click on other installation packages, and you're looking for this zip version here, which I've obviously already downloaded. So I will just expand this. You can use whatever software you want to extract that. So what we're going to do is just run the D-Fend exe. The default settings here are fine. They're just telling you that any games you add are being added to the folder where this is running. So say OK. So here on the right here, I've got my Settlers DOS version. Now you can obviously just Google for this. Most of the archives out there are the same. This particular one's been filtered with DOSCentre, which is like a DAP filtering tool, but you probably won't need to worry about that. So anyway, so all I simply do is drag the game into the window of D-Fend Reloaded, and it actually configures most of it already. But in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to change the default file that runs. This is so we can get the audio running. So we're just going to click on the little icon there, and I'm going to choose install, say open to select that. And now I'm just going to go to sound and Sound Blaster, and just make a note of this address, the interrupt, and the DMA. So 220, 7, and 1. Just remember that. And while I'm in here, I've just changed the graphics settings so you can see what I'm doing. So I'll take it out of full screen mode. I'm going to enable correct aspect ratio. I'm just going to change the render to OpenGL so that it looks a bit smoother when it's full screen. Anyway, so that's okay. So now I can double click to run. And from here, I'm just going to push number one on the keyboard to do setup. And we're going to push, because this is all DOS now, so this is just keyboard options. So I'm going to push up on the keyboard. Then I'm going to push enter. I'm going to keep pushing enter until we get to Creative Lab Sound Blaster. And this is the pro version. So I can already see the IO address is 220, which looks good. So I'm going to push right on the keyboard, push enter. And it looks like that's the pro version as well. And it has got the numbers 220, 7, and 1. So we're going to turn that on just by highlighting it with the cursors and then pushing enter. And we'll turn that on and we'll just say OK. I'll do a little check. Just push a key again, and just push escape to exit, and then push enter to get rid of that. And now all we've got to do is just change the file we want to run through D-Fend from the install. I'm going to choose just this is the main game. If you want to run through the intro, you can choose one of these bat files. I think this one will run intro and then settlers, and I think this one, I think it runs it at a lower resolution. I can't remember, but I'm just going to bypass them both and just start the main game. So open, say okay, now double click, wait for a little bit, and that's it. Hopefully this video was useful to you. If it was, please give me a thumbs up. Or if you'd like to subscribe, please do that. Thanks for watching.